Welcome to Talent Battle. Today, in our group discussion series, we will be talking about whether India is ready for a cashless economy or not. As usual, our group discussion will have four parts, that is the introduction, why is cashless economy necessary, the challenges, and the conclusion. Now, let's start with the introduction. Cash-concentrated economy in India. Money is the fundamental need of an economy. In a country like India, it is a fact of no doubt that it is an immensely cash-concentrated economy. Within the changing time and of course technology, a new term was introduced called the cashless economy. Now what is it actually? Cashless economy is used to describe the situation wherein the flow of cash doesn't exist within the economy and all the transactions are undertaken through electronic channels. This can include cash transfer through credit and debit cards, and direct debit and electronic clearing systems. Now why is cashless economy necessary? First is the high seniorage. When it comes to cash, an obvious fact is the significant amount of money and time needed to print the currency. According to some reports, RBI has spent $32.1 billion on printing the currency. One of the immediate benefits to the government would be a high seniorage. Seniorage is the profit from the printing of currency. Cashless money exists in the form of digits on computer and hence does not have to be printed. Attack on the parallel economy. Cash being the paper form of money is difficult to trace. Its transactions provide secrecy, enabling the people to carry out illegal activities. According to the government, the amount of black money circulated within the country goes up to 16 lakhs. Increase in the net tax. All the transactions that are done can be monitored and traced back to the given individual. If the officials from the tax department smell something fishy, then they can trace the money transaction back to that particular individual. Next is the job opportunities. India is a home to many successful mobile wallet companies such as Paytm and PhonePe, which shows its increasing success in bringing in the cashless trend. Also, the development of these apps gives employment opportunities to many. Effect of demonetization. Going cashless helps to curb corruption and hence increases the economic growth of the country. With the demonetization that took place in 2016, a large step was taken to initiate this concept. According to the Union Defense Minister, after demonetization, the crime rates in Mumbai have been decreased to half. Digitalization of the currency. Just by scanning a QR code, you can easily pay for the bills of local vegetable vendors, auto rickshaws, etc. Paytm saw a 700% increase in the total traffic and a 1000% increase in the amount of money added to its account within the first 2 days of the demonetization. Improvisations in the policies. When people go digital, a large amount of data is generated for every transaction that takes place. This means that we can find patterns in this data to improvise and analyze the government policies. Benefits of going cashless. During this period of global pandemic, the concept of being cashless has a very big boost to the economy. There is no direct handover of cash through which there can be a possibility of the spread of the virus. Now let's look at the aids given by the government. First one is the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana of 2014. This policy had the aim of getting a bank account for every household. This scheme ensures access to a range of financial services such as the saving bank accounts, access to need-based credit, insurance and pension. Next one is the direct benefit transfer. It is a scheme that was launched by the Government of India to transfer the benefits and subsidies of various local welfare schemes directly to the bank accounts of the beneficiaries. Next is the Unified Payment Service or the Unified Payment Interface. It is a system that powers multiple bank accounts into a single mobile application based on a UPI ID. Other promotions like e-banking, debit and credit cards, card swipe or POS machines and digital wallets have made the transition to the cashless economy easier. Now let's see what are the challenges to implement cashless economy. Challenges with the digitalization. India is a country having major businesses in the agricultural sectors. Expecting this sector of the population to suddenly adapt to the cashless trade is unadvisable. Connectivity issues. For using mobile wallets, it is necessary to have a secure internet connection, which is usually not available in the rural areas. Also, for transacting using the cards, a stable internet connection is important. effect of cash on GDP. The rate of cash to GDP is highest in India. In other economies, the average cash to GDP ratio is 5%, whereas in India, it goes up to 12.42%. Threats of using cards. The use of cards is dangerous if one does not have adequate knowledge about it. The card can be misused in case of theft, as the only thing you need to know for using a card is the 4-digit PIN. Cybercrime. The online transactions of money are highly dependent on the internet. Taking into consideration the growing cases of cyber attacks and cyber crimes, people have become reluctant to use these means. If one does not have a secured internet connection, then the entire savings of a lifetime could be put to risk. Transaction fees. The transaction fees charged by some banks are humongous. Also, the minimum balance policy of the banks is not affordable to all. Count of ATMs. India currently has only 2.3 lakh ATMs. This is a very less count as compared to the population and the area of the country. Now let's go to the conclusion. Taking it slow. Of course, suddenly shifting everything to the cashless trade is not going to help. It is necessary to proceed slowly and gradually. Monitoring the transaction fees. The bank must make sure that the transaction fee is either free or affordable to all. The minimum balance issues. The banks must encourage the opening of zero balance accounts to encourage the poor to make use of the bank accounts. Ensuring internet connectivity. The internet connectivity being a major issue in the rural areas should be treated by the government on priority to ensure secured internet connection to all. Promoting the use of cards. There must be sessions promoting the use of cards and tutorials to the illiterate about how to use the card and what are the precautions to be taken. Thus, making India cashless is a very strong concept, but it needs the support of proper infrastructure, tutoring, as well as a step-wise plan to succeed. Thank you.